Jain students, welcome back to the new activity. So dear, we have discussed about the term surplus. Okay, so surplus is what actually we have something in extra. Okay, after consuming it, or if I consume something from the produce, so the remaining part will be our surplus. So here we have an activity where three farmers are being given. So they are growing wheat in their field, okay, and their consumption will be the same, but their production will be the different. So here you can see there are different columns: production, consumption, surplus and capital for the next year, as well as three farmers are being given, farmer 1, 2 and 3. Columns for the every farmer data table will be same. So here you can see there are three subsequent years are being given, and the production is different from each farmer. Okay, and you can see the similarity between the consumption and consumption for every farmer. So what we are going to do is, here I have given example how did they find out the surplus. So surplus, the formula for finding out the surplus is production minus consumption. Okay, we will find out the surplus. So here production is 100 and consumption is 40, so the surplus will be 60, which will be used as capital for the next year. But what they are saying that capital and that surplus which you will be using for the next year, it should be twice for taking as the for next year production. Okay, so here you can see I will give you one example how to find out this. If I want to find out the surplus for the second year, I have to deduct 40 from 120. I will get 80, okay, which will be the capital for next year. But if I talk about production, from where do I got the production for the third year, it should be twice the previous year or capital, okay, which should be used as the next year production. So here 160 will be the production for the third year. So now if I deduct 160 from 40 from 160, sorry, so it you will get 120 as surplus. Okay, so here capital for the next year will be 120. So this is how you have to find out the data for each table for the second and third farmer. What you have to do after that, you have to compare the production of wheat by three farmers over the years. What happens to third farmer in third year? Can he continue production? What will he have to do to continue production? So in this three tables, first one I have solved for you. What you have to do is to solve second and third farmer table and find out and compare that what happens to the production of wheat by three farmers over the years. Write in paragraphs some points you can write, and what happened to the farmer 3 particularly. Can he continue production after third year? You have to find out what actually comes out. So here this is the activity, and this is your homework. Complete it by 6 p.m. Monday. Till that you have to submit it to me on my WhatsApp number. So dear, I hope you are doing well, and if you find any difficulty, you can feel free to ask me anytime. I am available here. So thank you so much, and be motivated, and have dedication to your studies. Jai Hind.